Welcome back to the 2-Minute Warning. Today, I am looking at the Cleveland Browns determining whether or not they should sign free agent Jadeveon Clowney. But before we get into that topic, question for those of you viewing, especially Browns fans. The Browns have the 26th pick in the first round of the upcoming 2021 NFL Draft. For those of you viewing, comment down below who you want to see the Browns take in this first round, and I will reveal my answer at the end. But getting to this topic, looking at Jadeveon Clowney, came in I believe 2014 as the first pick in the NFL draft to the Houston Texans. I don't want to say he was overrated, but there was a lot of hype around him, and we thought he'd be the next J.J. Watt. Him and Jadeveon alongside would just rain sacks in that Houston's defense. However, got hurt. He wasn't what we thought he was, and then he went to Seattle, and we thought he could maybe change their defense and be the guy there, and then he kind of wasn't. He had his instances of greatness, but then he went to Tennessee this past year. He thought he could help that pass rush out, help that defense, and then he got hurt. So he hasn't had the prettiest career being healthy and, you know, racking up numbers. But to say Jadeveon Clowney is not a good player is just insane. Yes, he's had his instances of being overvalued, and yes, he gets hurt here and there, but when he is healthy and when he's on that field, his presence, his size, his capability, his skill is great, it is good, and it is worth the dollars if you could get Jadeveon Clowney on a value deal. He knows he's coming off an injury, he knows he's looking for a one-year prove-it deal, and he knows he just isn't what we thought he was going to be, so the Cleveland Browns might be able to get him on a relatively cheap contract. Cheap as in millions of dollars, we're still talking, but probably anywhere $5 million or less, because like I said, he's going to be on a one-year prove-it deal more likely than not. He's already visited with the Browns. Browns defensive tackle Malik Jackson already said he's welcome to come. And theoretically, if you can afford him, I think the Browns have around $10 million in cap space right now, according to Over the Cap. But you have to save a little bit of money for the draft, so you can't spend all $10 million on him. But that's, I don't think he's worth $10 million, but I do think a $5, $6 million value contract that is probably incentive based could really help this Browns defense a lot. Looking at the Browns roster, their defense has already taken a huge step this past year. I mean, looking at what they got, they added John Johnson and Troy Hill, so that secondary is looking like a number one corner, Denzel Ward, hopefully a healthy Greedy Williams, and like I said, John Johnson, Troy Hill, a great safety and good slot corner. Looking at the pass rush, it used to just kind of be Myles Garrett, but now you got him a little bit of help. You got Myles Garrett, Sheldon Richardson, Malik Jackson, hopefully Takaris McKinley gets rolling, and Jadeveon Clowney. Just on paper, this Browns roster on defense is a top 10 defense in my opinion, but if you added Jadeveon Clowney and he's healthy and he's good, you can account for a top 8, top 7 defense from the Cleveland Browns in my opinion. But we will just have to see if Jadeveon Clowney goes there and gets hurt again. We don't know. I mean, history's shown he's just not going to play a full 16 games. He is just not going to. Something will happen, but having a defensive line that has some depth to it now, a Takaris McKinley, a Malik Jackson, Sheldon Richardson, and Myles Garrett, we don't need Jadeveon Clowney to start every single game, and he could just come in on certain times we want to blitz or create extra pressure or take some pressure off of Myles Garrett. He doesn't have to be there every single snap, every single game, therefore 17 games this season now, but therefore, he doesn't have to be the healthiest person ever. You want to see him be able to play a full season, of course, if you want to invest in him further years after this one-year possible deal. But we just don't know. That's a good chance he's not going to. He just hasn't shown to do that. But if he does, somehow, some way, this Browns defense, like I said, could be a top eight defense in the NFL. Just looking at the roster all around, you got the highest paid offensive lineman. You got the best backfield in the NFL between Nick Chubb, Kareem Hunt. Baker Mayfield's probably up in a top 10 quarterback position right now. He's gonna be well coached for Kevin Stefanski. He's gonna finally get some consistency in his offense. His receiving core is very stout, as we know, as OBJ is coming back, so a healthy OBJ, a great slot receiver in Jarvis Landry, a double tight end threat in Austin Hooper, David Njoku. You re-sign Rashard Higgins, and then looking at the defense, I already named it: Troy Hill, John Johnson, Denzel Ward, Myles Garrett, Takaris McKinley, and maybe now Jadeveon Clowney. This Browns team, on paper, might be one of the best ones in the NFL. I have them making the AFC Championship, but Jadeveon Clowney could be a cherry on top type of player that can make them a Super Bowl type of team that can win an AFC Championship. I even think now the Browns do have a possible Super Bowl roster if Baker Mayfield could step up and be their guy of the future. But AFC Championship is what I'm going to go with. Just, I don't want to say in a conservative route because that's still a tough destination, but they made it to the divisional round last year, and they got better than this year. So I think AFC Championship is likely. They have the roster to do it, but will they or should they add a Jadeveon Clowney? To me, it is yes, but it all depends on the price. Is he okay with the $5 to $6 million year deal? Like I said, Malik Jackson's already welcomed him. The Browns have already talked to him, and he's not going to get signed today. He's probably going to get signed on draft day or after the draft or right before the draft to kind of help things, help evaluate things. If they get him before the draft, then they know not to really focus on defensive line much more in the NFL draft. If they get him during the draft or after the draft, you know what I mean? It's just easier to evaluate when you get him around that time versus today, more likely than not. But, of course, if he's not, if he's got rocks in his head and he doesn't understand that he's not worth $11, $12 million anymore just because we don't know what he's going to be. He's coming off an injured season. He's been overrated at times, and we just don't know what he is. He's going to have to play it on a prove-it deal. He needs to understand that, but if he doesn't, the Browns, you can't spend every penny you have left in free agency on a risky type of player. This is a gamble play, but it could turn out big, and if you get a healthy Jadeveon Clowney that could play a full season when you got a star power roster such as a Myles Garrett, Jadeveon Clowney, Denzel Ward, Troy Hill, John Johnson, like I said, and it's well coached and Kevin Stefanski, this might be an even better than top eight defense. If you have a seriously healthy Jadeveon Clowney, they can make the push for top five. I know that's bold, but star power wise they have it, and depth wise they have it. We just have to see, will injuries stay away? Will they still be well coached? How will they perform on the field? On paper they're great, but when they're actually playing together, will the chemistry and playing style work together and overlap well? We don't know, but on paper they could fight for a top five spot if you added Jadeveon Clowney and he's healthy. Like I said, I know that is bold, but I'm not saying they are, but I think they can make the push for it. It's still the Rams and Bucks out there that have great defenses, and a lot of other teams, Colts, Steelers in your own division, won't be easy, but like I said, the possibility of pushing for top five is there if you add Jadeveon Clowney. But even if not, there are other routes to go if you do not sign him. There's other free agents. There's KJ Wright. You could probably use a linebacker. That's probably one of the weaker spots on that Browns team. I like your front line, and I like your secondary, but the linebacker core is not the strongest. So KJ Wright would help, or Justin Houston to help out the pass rush as well. I doubt they'll go KJ Wright or Justin Houston. I think Jadeveon Clowney, it's him or go for the draft. But if they choose to go other routes than free agency, there are possible outcomes that they can choose to follow outside of Jadeveon Clowney. But like I said, he's been overrated at times. He's injury prone. But if you don't think the player is good, you're just insane. Jadeveon Clowney is a good player when he's healthy and can give it it all, give it his all. His presence is amazing and his skill is amazing. And he just needs those things to click and he needs to turn his career around. And I think the Browns is a place to do it because, like I said, they have the depth to where they don't need him play in and play out. He can find a role that fits him. I'm excited to see what the Browns do. I really think they should find what he's going to cost, and then if it's the right value, go for it. Like I said, it's a wild card play, but the cherry on top, this could be the cherry on top that takes them to the Super Bowl. But like I said, comment down below your guys' thoughts on Jadeveon Clowney, if you think you should sign him, and of course, who you think they should take in the NFL draft. 26 overall, I would not be surprised. Kwity Paye, Jalen Phillips, Gregory Rousseau, those are probably, in my opinion, the top three pass rushers in this NFL draft. It's not likely you're going to get your pick of the three, but there is a decent chance one of those three guys fall down to 26. Not high, but there is a chance. And if one of those three fall, I think the Browns should snatch him up. Jadeveon Clowney or not, I think that is a steal at 26 overall. And if you got Jadeveon Clowney and you pick up Jalen Phillips, he's probably the most likely to fall of these three, I guess, between Kwity Paye, Gregory Rousseau, whoever you think is most likely. If you pick up one of those three and Jadeveon Clowney, you're looking at one of the best pass rushes in the NFL. And even if you don't sign Jadeveon Clowney, this possible pickup would have replaced him. Either way, those would be my ideal picks if you could steal one of those three, but it is unlikely. But of course, comment your ideas, guys, and I really appreciate it. Thanks for watching.